There is no instance of a nation benefiting from prolonged warfare. Sun Tzu. I guess you are somewhat Chinese. Well, anyways, hello everyone. I am Sacred and thank you for joining me in my let's play of Hearts of Iron 4 as the Russian Federation. Well, we are playing as Russia, so we have to do the Russian greeting as well, don't we? So, всем привет, дорогие друзья. Меня зовут Сакрет, и давайте поиграем День Победы 4. Well, let's get straight into the game, shall we? Let's let the game load properly and increase its volume. There we go, 2.5. My volume should be just fine. Single player load and yeah, Russia let's play Millennium Dawn. There we go, let's go ahead and see. So currently we are, well, reactionary, but I tried it out and no reactionary countries will join us. So if we make the countries even reactionary, they will most likely not join us in a case of an offensive war. So that's the bad thing about reactionary, about being reactionary. But nevertheless, this shouldn't be a problem. We will still, well, do whatever is in our hands to make the NATO collapse. Because, I mean, we could possibly win against the, well, I mean, you can see that the Constitution Party cannot advance anymore. It's just going up and going down, so its maximum is 30% popularity. The Republican Party is 37 and the Democratic Party is 32. So yeah, perhaps that's the problem. And I don't think we'll be ever able to continue in that case. Now let's get the thermal weapon sight. If you check the NATO is truly bloody damn huge. Truly huge, world energy is at 40%. So, against which other, well, not so important country who possibly wouldn't even join the NATO could we declare war? Let's see. I mean, we could declare war against the Chinese. The Chinese are 41, they are, I mean, majority they are highly conservative. But I don't view the Chinese as a, well, mortal enemy of the Russian Federation. I mean, the NATO is a way mortal, a way, well, intense enemy than the, well, wait, than the America, yeah, great, then the America, great English, then America. Yeah, we wanna do greater Russia and then perhaps Ukraine the crosshair, although we can't advance anymore because, yeah, because simply we, well, Ukraine doesn't exist, that's the thing. Well, stand with Japan, stand with China, with democracy, yeah, of course. Do you think I'd like to stay with democracy? No. Well, perhaps I should, yeah, let's simply do the diplomatic focus. Try to advance in there, but I'm really seeking for a country to conquer. Yeah, what about Azerbaijan? Azerbaijan, they have lots of oil. They have 7 civilian, 10 to 12, 7 military, 10 to 11 to 12 steel factories. I mean, they are reactionary, but the problem is, you see, neither they nor we are at war. But the Georgians might be a, well, mortal threat to the Russian country. I mean, they serve as a buffer between us and Turkey, so it would be possibly smart to keep them there as a buffer state. I mean, or we could fight against the Turks as well, but that has to be counted with. I'd say, nevertheless, we should go for the annexation of Georgia. Yeah, we should go for the annexation of Georgia. What about, well, the Transnistrian Republic? They are communist. They are so far and good, well, communist, they are even being guaranteed by us. Look to that. Who would have expected that? Finland isn't that strong either, not that big of a threat. Question is, well, Iran likes us quite a bit. Iran opinion. They get, well, quite a bit of trade against from us. They are Islamist and I doubt that they'll join our faction. I guess we just simply cannot get anyone joining our faction, so sad it may seem like. And is it time to capture Georgia? I mean, then we can defend our Armenian allies. Therefore, let's go ahead, justify a war goal against Georgia. There we go. It will be done on 29th of December 2004. Perhaps Georgia and Azerbaijan. Perhaps I should get these two countries under my command. Yeah, let's do that. Let's get Georgia and Azerbaijan under Russian supremacy. Can I do it right now? I can. There we go. Justifying against two, well, independent nations. But, I mean, independency is a term which is loosely being used. It really isn't that important if the country is independent or not. Nevertheless, we will make it back a part of the Soviet Union. I mean, of the former territories of the Soviet Union, because I'm sure the Russian people would like to see Russia and its old power for extend anymore. Any? What about Mongolia? Mongolia is doing the military build-up. The military build-up. Well, I mean, they have nothing we can use. They have really nothing we could use. But if we capture them, we'll have a really long, well, border against the Chinese, which may overextend our force, but which also may overextend their army, because the border will stretch all the way from Tajikistan all the way to Manchuria then. Probably the longest border in the world that will be then if we get Mongolia on our side. Yeah, never thought of that, did we? Okay, I have to queue in more civilian factories. I can just smell it already, therefore we shall do that. Let's build up Rosval, Bryansk, Aryol, Lipetsk, Tambov, Penza, Voronezh, Cherbosari, Kazan, Ijevsk, Kirov, Valgada, Alanets, Saratov, Ulyanovsky, what's that? Kubishev, Yengels, Mikhailovka, Mirava. Okay, that we shall build up. So, yeah. Russia is getting lots of civil factories. We are readying ourselves for the war against the NATO. Well, the war, it may take really, but in 2015 we should be fully prepared, but we have to prepare fully, because the NATO, if we are not able to get any other countries on our side, the NATO is a truly strong enemy, which we have to reckon with as a true enemy force. None of the countries have left the NATO. Damn it. I mean, France is I'm boosting, yeah. The France, we know, has 52%. I mean, they should leave it. But Germany, I'm boosting it in which countries? In Brazil, France, China, India, US. Let's check in India, okay, in China, okay. Well, they have no elections now. In Brazil, I mean, it's so easy to get your party up and rolling, but the problem is that the country simply do not want to join you. That's so sad. Yeah, we can't go for that focus, so our Russian focus tree was set aside finally, is sadly done. Do we want to do the path of the eagle, trade with the west? Or path of the bear? I'd say that we should do the path of the bear. I mean, we can do all of that. Let's do the path of the dragon. Path of the bear. Let's do that. Our own path is always the best path. That's how it always was. Oh, it will be. Well, let's do the path of the dragon, just to see if it changes the Chinese opinion against us. Meanwhile, our army, well, is still a bit getting developed. We have a shortage on light mechanized, motorized, and infantry equipment. About motorized, I think we can fix that. We still have the light mechanized. Let's replace him with motorized infantry. Then it should be just fine. Now, yeah, we have a good surplus of mechanized and light mechanized. 1.9 thousand, 1.9 thousand. That's fine. No, I mean 34,000. What was the equipment, though? Yeah, truly. That's sad, but whatever. Yeah, the rest can stay just in reserve. I'd say I have no problem with that. Okay, readying ourselves against invasion of Georgia, which should be done quite soon. It will be done. Yeah, and Azerbaijan. So goodbye, Heydar Aliyev. It will be 9th of January 2005. 9th of January. But the Kampfgruppe. Smirna! George W. Bush has won. Such a big surprise, isn't it? Chloe. Smirna! Alright, yeah, let's get 19 divisions into the Sergei Shoigu's army. Sign him against Azerbaijan. Let's get these fresh units of, let's create a new motorized army here. And yeah, let's see, come on, let's get 24. Taking some while, but it will be worth it. 24, let's create a new theater. against Georgia and Azerbaijan. There we go. And let's name the front Kavkazsky Front. Kavkazsky Front, which stands for Caucasus Front, I guess, yeah. The general will be, let's get the Field Marshal Anatoly Antonov. Yeah, and Field Marshal Sergei Shoigu. Okay, Belgol push against Baku like that. And from the 7th Army, just push against Tbilisi, I guess that's correct. Tbilisi, yeah. Of course, we don't need the desperate defense, because we are not desperate. We shall never be that desperate, never. We will get the modern blitzkrieg instead. What was that? China, oh yeah. We cannot trade with the east, stand with China. Stand with China, trade with the west. Let's stand with China, shall we? Yeah, let's stand with China. I mean, we can support Assad. Support the Kims. Let's stand with China. Also, we can either stand with Japan or stand with China. Thing is, do I want to seek Indian friendship or... Well, let's do the path. Tibia, perhaps. Well, we can modernize the army, but only for... Well, that's nice one. Motorized production cost minus 20%. I think that's for what I want to go for, so I'll go for that. Yeah, it's really... It seems just nice. In China, obviously, the reactionaries are the leading force. In Brazil as well, in the US, they can't. In France, they are. We can cancel the boost of popularity. We can keep it going there. In China, let's cancel boost. There we go. Let's do the start the Russo-Georgian war. Just wanna claim our territory back. That's nothing bad, is it? Declare war? Well, I'm just gonna say, because I don't wanna start World War 3, so it shouldn't really be the reason for World War 3. So, just declare war, call all allies. Russia goes to war. All of the blots. Russia have failed. They will now sort out their differences with their enemy on the battlefield. And Russia can go in Georgia. And there we go. We're calling all of our allies. Let's see how long... Oh, the war is done already. Look to that, I think. Well, what happened to the Georgian defense? I mean, that was really too fast. I think that. I'll just take Georgia, thank you, and there we go. I took one state, that 7,058 equipment has been seized. Well, now it's about Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan, I guess. Royce! We shall... Here. Run it in the into the territory at once. Against Baku. The war should be a fast one. And Nakhchivan, I think the Armenians should just be fine, just moving into the territory. There we go. Voltage is rising, but we don't mind. Let's get the... Alright, justification of Ganja, Ganya for Russia is finished, that's great. Open and yeah, it's ahead. More special forces, we wanna go. And Azerbaijan, I'm sorry, but declare war. Oh, what? Coup in Republic of China, a coup happens. Oh, what? What? A coup happened? China is reactionary now. China is reactionary. What in the name of God just happened? What in the name of God just happened? Our, well, our boost did really work. China just became reactionary. Look to that. Wow, I really wouldn't have expected that. Perhaps, well, we even don't get the same ideology. That's such a sad thing. Improve relations. That may work things out. Well, plus five for the same. I don't. That's a joke. It should be like plus 50. At plus five, that rather feels quite a joke here. But well, there we go. China is no more communist. No more communist. Instead, they are a republic. Well, okay. Let's cancel the boost of popularity. Still boosting it in France. No, we aren't. Okay. Germany is befriending Brazil. Brazil is mainly reactionary, though. The French will have their election in June 2005. I mean, the Americans, they aren't doing anything. They aren't doing the Arakis war. Why did I simply pick Sorge focuses if the AI isn't doing anything? That's, yeah. We only have one tier only, but our army is getting quite, well, high inflation. Oh, Wow, damn, we have 10,000 light mechanized surplus. I think the Georgians had lots of. We just seized all of the Georgians' light mechanized supply. Yeah, I guess. Okay, we have 3 civilian. I wanna build it up more. Let's build it in the Petsk, Voronezh, Tambov, Penza, Ryazan, Gorky, Ivanova, Yaroslavl, Kalinin, Tikhvin, Rzhev, Smolensk, Kaluga, Yaroslavl, Bryansk, Oryol, Belgorod, Nivel, Pskov, Valkhov, Kirov, Chebari, Ijevsk, Kazan. Okay, there we go. So we are getting quite the, well, quite the powerhouse here, quite the huge powerhouse. Okay, Azerbaijan, declare war and call allies. Russia goes to war. All diplomats of Russia have failed. They will now sort out their differences with the enemy on the battlefield. May the heavens help us. Declare war at once, and let's see when the war will be done. What is going on in every front? There we go, our army pushing relentlessly. China still doesn't want to join our faction. We have a war. What? Are they afraid of fighting? We have a war they may be drawn into, so we have to get somebody attacking us. That's sad. Oh, Belarus, nice. I'm gonna gladly take your divisions, although it's only 5. There we go, the push is continuing. Drive towards Baku, and settlement of Azerbaijani units. 4,000 to 251, and America isn't backing them. And the USA isn't backing them, such a shame. Iran is Islamist, no problem, and there we go, what? So, Armenia has a claim on Nakhchivan, but I'll have to take everything, I'm sorry. I'll have to even take Nakhchivan, Armenia, I'm sorry, to get no problems there with you. There we go. Russia took 4 states. Azerbaijan was the next. 12th engine is at 71% already. So, yeah. We have really ignored. We wanted to, well, not raise it that high. But we did raise it quite high. And now the US have enacted nothing. Great. They still have the civilian economy focus. Alright, now we can, well, I do not plan to do any other campaigns against other states. The campaign which I'll plan now will be against the all of NATO, against the whole NATO. June is a date we all await. And, but probably France won't leave the NATO. Brazil, US, China. Okay. Stop in China, that's really worth it. So, what it's saying, I'm still boosting it in China. In Republic of China. Okay, improving relations, that's why. Neither they nor we are at war, so we really can't get them to join us. And we can't suck the focus which will make them join us. That's so sad. We should, sadly. The Russian army, because I wanna get the three there, the CSTO. We have a core population of 143 million, and an encore of 58 million, which is, well, just alright, I would say. So because Moldova isn't in the NATO, yeah, they aren't in NATO, so we have to, let's reorganize our fronts. This huge front will be our main thrust. I mean, we'll have to make multiple fronts. So these 60 divisions will lead the thrust against not only Estonia. Oh, I have to tell them here. A fallback line between Estonia, Latvia, etc. From Belarus, so this will be our main thrust. Like that, to connect areas, a little province. There we go, bordering the area. This will be my main thrust, my main army will tack into this sector. Perhaps this will be the, I don't know, Baltic front. Do we need a Baltic front? Right, perhaps, but the strongest front should be divided into this sector. So I'll make 2 different fronts. The first fallback line will be the front against Poland. Like that. Against Poland and its allies. Let's say against Poland only. There we go. Against Poland and Slovakia. Units are moving on their way. These 24 will form, oh, I think 24 aren't enough. They can't stay against Turkey, I'd say. Yeah, they'll defend themselves against the Turks and push perhaps as well. 24 we assigned there. But you know what, since the Turks won't be our main battlefield, I will assign these units to the Turkish front, these 19 divisions, which I'll not use efficiently. There we go, that sounds like a better plan for me. Sergei Shoigu, you will be the leader of the front, let's say of the Kaliningrad front, yeah. So we're gonna send you into St. Petersburg and then you're gonna depart to the Oblast of Kaliningrad, where we'll start our major operations from as well. Research for Weibel. Radar, I really don't need radar. Although I could need a air doctrine and a better armored roll fighter. I should start developing it soon. I mean, our we have 200, near to 200 civilian factories. Don't forget, we have 200. That's quite a bit. We did surely overcome the US. The US has, 167. Although they have more military than us, but I don't expect the whole army to be in war against us. It's like the technology, air doctrine. There we go. What if my government, communists, god damn it, yeah. Military staff, let's get the army offense, yeah. During attack, plus 5%, burp, can always be useful and helpful. Vnimanie, yeah. You'll be only, well, sorted to, here. Yeah. Max entrenchment, that's what I want, therefore you're gonna get that lot. Just entrench, excuse me, just entrench yourself in the mountainous region there. The might of the NATO. Strong enemy powerhouse, certainly. Oh, well, our main enemy will still be the US, so... But, yeah, we are planning way too deep operations, and still, Yugoslavia is still alive. The game's rather boring. I would have expected more things to happen, but they aren't. The invasion of Iraq isn't happening with whatever reason. That's simply sad, to be honest. I'm kind of disappointed, but nevertheless, well, it's fun to play. So the CSTO, well, yeah, we control most of the former Soviet territory except the Baltic states, Moldavia, and these two Turkish states here of Turkmenistan and Uzbekistan, which are quite weak though. There we go. Our next conqueror of war will be against the NATO. The Poles, they have many units. The Polish. That's probably many units. 53-97. After my current wave, I will start building military factories. Enough. We've built enough civilians one. Time for military factories. We still need lots of units, that's certainly safe. We have minus 26,000, but I can perhaps even build some light mechanized units, some strong spearheading mechanized divisions, perhaps. But let's go to division designer, yeah? And let's create a new one from scratch, so create empty. You'll get Breaking Company, Sport Artillery, Signal Company, Field Hospital, as well as the Engineer Company. Let's say, yeah. And you're gonna be consist of, let's see, we have lots of light mechanized and mechanized, therefore, these two. Mobile, light mechanized. Oh, mobile. Light mechanized, and one all mechanized, let's see. Also, let's modify our here by our motorized rifle brigade, adding him a signal company as well as a engineer. Oh, we can only add this engineer company. Well, fine, should be fine. Engineer company, there we go. Now we need more support equipment as well. Yeah, there you see, doing the war against NATO isn't so easy. Well, you may have thought. Plus, I wanna do a spontaneous invasion of the US, but the problem is, how do we get there? It's a long way. Our navy, we can send our navy there, but it's a long way to the west coast of the United States. A truly long way, and forcing their capitulation is a hard thing. So, in case of war, I will stage a coup there, and then I will invite the cooing country to my faction, and then things should work ostensibly. Nivelle, Gonjev, Benza, Tambov. Now we are building out our military sector. Research for Weibel. We wanna get the most pristine equipment, but that's still out of time. engineer company, we can upgrade perhaps. Currently we have 221 civilian factories and 25 nuclear bombs. 11 nuclear reactors are contributing to this, well, production of our nuclear arsenal. We got motorized forces, which gave us a nice boost of minus 20% cost. So now, I mean, land upgrade we are done, we really don't need that. Let's the Russian Navy naval production. 3 naval dockets are always helpful. Now let's go for naval production. There we go. Always nice to get some naval, 3 naval dockets. Probably I'm just getting many light cruisers, and our navy is, well, 49,000 strong. This is all of one carrier, 5 missile cruisers, 19 light cruisers, and 18 destroyers. Первая советская флотилия. It is the CSTO. Well, I mean, the world is quite boring, nothing's really going on, so in my next let's play, when I play in this episode, I shall play in the 2016, well, version of the mods. Although this one is recommended, we can still do that. Let's build out our eastern sector here, let's build out the territories here, we haven't built them out at all. Let's build them out, time to advance, isn't it? There we go, build them out, fine and red will. Build out the sector around Volgograd. Alright, great. Now we'll sit back and wait. We got a new gen 4.5 multi-roll. Great. And naval. Naval-wise, let's perhaps get the combat defense. There we go. 3 military factories. Time to get more motorized. Actually, more support equipment, and then I'm gonna queue in more. I'm gonna queue in one, yeah, multi-roll fighter as well. Complete line of multi-roll fighters, then as well, motorized. We have ambitious plans. We have truly ambitious plans. Well, they shall all be fulfilled though. Army division attrition is nice. Concealment, artillery, attack defense, armor division, attack defense. Well, that's all. I don't know. About armor, we forgot about our armor. Your guard tank brigade. Don't know why we have motorized infantry with it. We need it. Well, it doesn't remove the speed, so it's 14.3 anyways. Yeah, let's keep it in. It's infantry. Gvardiyskaya Tankovnaya Divizia. Safe. Guards Tank Brigade. We are gonna deploy them in Moskva. Moskva. 26 Guards Tanks Divisions. We have an ambitious plan, which will require ambitious resources. There we go, yeah, light mechanized type 1, sure, why not train it in Moskva. 11 divisions are somewhat alright, 11 divisions, we reached the limits, and we're coming close to reaching the limit of our manpower usage as well. I may be able to create a fully mechanized army, although most of them I got from Ukraine and Georgia. So we are using Georgian and Ukrainian vehicles here in the Russian military. So, controversial as it might seem, we are actually doing that. Well, time to get, I'd say, a conscription. Or extended one. Well, let's get, I guess, well, let's get limited. We have 52 million. That seems enough for the current moment. Providing experience, no focus set, carrier program, naval prosecution program. Our inner three is rising. China is nothing compared to us. Russia is a new world power. I'm doing the Asian Alliance. What's the Asian Alliance? Asian Alliance. Oh, that tree is truly huge, although I want to see the Asian Alliance. They will invite. Oh, they will create a faction and not join our faction. Okay, I see. Why did I make them bloody reactionary? That's. It didn't help me at all. Yeah. They have to improve the term reactionary here, because look, the Front National, Jean-Marie Le Pen. I mean, the reactionary party is living in France, but nevertheless. Didn't really work out that well, did it? Not, it really didn't. So, we're still boosting it in India, US, Brazil, but I will stop it because it doesn't help. It doesn't bring anything perhaps just in US, but in the rest it doesn't really help us at all, therefore it shouldn't, yeah, bore with it. So in China they are the strongest one, but I'll cancel it because it doesn't help. So, well, the game would be perhaps too easy if it would have worked, therefore, yeah, we can view it the pawn as well. It may have been too easy. Perhaps it may have been, yeah. Smyrna. Except it's, oh, you're gonna be shifting into Kaliningrad. Kaliningrad. I'll say lead the thrust against the Polish frontier. Polish front. Although, yeah, there's two fronts here, Lithuania and Poland. It's a problem. It is alright. There we go. Gonna be assigned to this front line. So the Poles are getting scared when they see this tremendous amount of troops, of Russian troops massing on the border. But we'll just call it a military exercise. Nothing to worry about. Just a peaceful military exercise. The Asian Economic and Defense Union. A new international alliance has appeared on the world stage as the Chinese leadership announced the creation of the Asian Economic and Defense Union, or AEDU. If regional powers align themselves with this new military and economic bloc, it will surely bolster Chinese power in the region. Well, only Hong Kong and Macau, only the Chinese allies joined it, nothing, nobody else. Well, it's so sad we can't form the Shanghai Pact. Yeah. Well, okay. Anyways, I'll take a cut here, a break, so thank you all for watching me. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Sacred, and I'm out. See you next time, and goodbye.